for you to win the Heisman Trophy Award tomorrow?
Right now, I'm not really worried about the Heisman Trophy. I'm just trying to come in with the team this weekend. Just look forward to getting onto the game plan for Ohio State.
Next up, we'll hear from Ralph Russo.
Hey, DeVonta. Okay, well, I'll try a little different version of a Heisman question for you. Do you look at yourself as sort of like representing all receivers? In other words, receivers don't usually win this award. They often don't get even to be a finalist. Amari Cooper did, but it's not that often. Do you take some pride of sort of like representing not just yourself, but receivers?
I guess you can say that, just showing that it really just the person that goes out and just puts in the work, they're going to get the things that they deserve. So if you work for things, you're going to get the things that you deserve.
Next up, we'll hear from Mark Stallworth. Mark?
How you doing, DeVonta? Welcome to Miami. Just had a question. It seems like you're very familiar with playing in Hard Rock Stadium. So could you explain, I guess, having your last game here at the Orange Bowl, and how do you plan on utilizing that familiarity with the field to your advantage this week?
It really don't matter what we play at. Just spot the ball. I'm ready.
All right. Next up will be Pat Murphy. Patrick?
DeVonta, I'm curious just what you've seen from Ohio State's secondary, specifically Sean Wade. He came back this year to kind of prove himself. And I'm curious your perspective on what he's done and the matchup that you guys will have with that secondary.
I really haven't watched film yet. I haven't got the chance to watch film yet. I'm going to kind of dig into it today. So hopefully I get into it today and I can see some things that's interesting for us.
All right, next we'll hear from Steve Mouton. Steve Mouton.
Hey, DeVonta, congratulations on a successful season. I can't help but want to ask really where you got that team before me kind of mentality, because we obviously hear it in these answers. So tell me a little bit of your background and why the team mentality kind of is ingrained in you.
Just because you're not out there playing by yourself. With team success comes individual success. So if the team's doing good, then everybody's doing good, and that's what it all comes down to.
Okay, next we'll hear from Scott Rabels. Scott?
All right, can you hear me? Sorry for that. You've always been a big part of the offense going back to your freshman year, but with Jalen getting hurt earlier this year, how did that change your role, or did it change your attitude and feeling like I have to be more of a contributor to this offense or a leader in this offense?
Well, just me being the competitor I am, I wanted to just do whatever I can to help the team, and that's what it came down to. Just everybody on the offense feel like they can do more to help the team, and that's what we all been trying to do.
All right, next up we'll hear from Michael Casagrande.
Yeah, DeVonta, you remember that 2018 team that was undefeated to this point in the season and didn't finish the way you wanted in California. How is that a motivating factor this week to keep this legacy of this team, undefeated, as opposed to a team that came this close and almost got there?
The past is the past. Nothing we can do about it now. We're just focusing on this week and how we can prepare for this game and just make sure that it doesn't happen again.
Next up, we'll hear from Joseph Goodman. Joseph?
Mute. Yeah. Hey, DeVonta, congratulations on the amazing season. I was hoping you could talk to me a little bit about how the power of believing in yourself has shaped your life. And also, I wanted you to kind of clue me into when you got your first when you got your last growth spurt. I think you went from 125 at some age when you were in high school. Was this right?
I was reading
back through some stories.
I don't remember, but it was probably somewhere around that.
How has the power of believing in yourself then shaped your life?
Just you got to believe in the things you do. If you don't believe in it, then why are you doing it? You can't just be out here doing something that you don't believe in. So you put your mind to some things, and eventually it's going to happen.
How many people told you you couldn't be a football player?
I heard it a lot all my life.
Thanks.
Next, we'll hear from Luke Krause. Luke?
Hear me?
Yes, we can now.
Okay. Coming into the college football playoff, Ohio State had some disrespect to the program, with people saying they do not deserve to get in. Were y'all looking ahead to Clemson playing in the national championship? And was it a shock to you that Clemson lost and you'll now have to face Ryan Day's Ohio State?
I mean, I'm not part of the committee, so I have no say-so in who they put in or who they wanted to put in. At the end of the day, we just show up here, practice, and get ready for whoever the next opponent is.
Next up will be Jeff Spiegel. Jeff?
Yes, DeVonta. Last year's Citrus Bowl, how important do you think that game was in terms of a launching off point for this 2020 team?
I think it was very important just to give everyone something to think about of how like the season went, and it wasn't where we wanted to be, but just to end everything on a good note to kind of be like, okay, we see what next year is going to look like, and we know we have to do to get things right.
We have time for two more questions. The next will be from Mike Rodak. Mike?
DeVonta, how did Sark break the news that he was going to Texas, and what was the reaction among players?
We had a meeting. Coach Saban told us about it. I mean, everybody's happy for Coach Sark. I mean, that's part of the business. But he's going to be here with us throughout this last game, and we're trying to finish things the right way.
And our final question today will be from Rob Aller. Rob?
Hey, DeVonta, the Nick Saban you see is not the Nick Saban we see. If you had to describe him to somebody on the outside, how would you do that?
He's very funny. It may not seem like it to y'all, but he has a sense of humor.
You have an example of that? And how often do you see it?
Every day at practice. It's always every day at practice.
All right. Thank you very much, DeVonta. Best of luck. We'll see you later in the week.